Hey, let's just jump right in with the RB5 upgrade. First thing I'm working on is getting this trim off, and I did not have any proper tools. Don't think you can use frickin' plastic knives. It's way too bendy. And I tried some of these, it's a little bit too thick. What I found perfect, if you have toddlers or kids, they're forks. It's a lot stiffer than the knife, especially this back end, really stiff. So what I did is I started in this corner right here, and I just got one, two, three, kind of the power of three. It's really hard with one. Kind of did that, pressure behind it, and popped one side out. Now I'm gonna do the whole rest of it, not on camera, but you need something really stiff to do this. It didn't damage anything. That's what I'm most going extra slow for. So let me see if I can get this bezel off to start with. I now have the whole bottom off. The top is real stuck here. I don't have any screw under the top of your instrument cluster here. It said some will have it, some won't. There's no screw up by the steering wheel here, so I'm just gonna have to keep trying and keep tugging. Oh my God, that's hard. Well, I got it off. This left side driver's side vent stayed in there. Almost lost a clip. I found a clip somewhere. Hope I didn't drop too much. Luckily, this new bezel comes with clips. I just got it. Once I get it out and all organized, I gotta see what's what, if I'm missing any parts here. The next step is going to be to disconnect the harnesses from behind this screen, which is part of the bezel. So I'm gonna commence, sit in the passenger side, look back here, and try to work on these connections next. Move the camera for a sec. So I got three connections. One of them went right into that plug there that I unplugged. I just pushed down at the top. Push in a little bit is the trick that everybody talks about here, just to make sure that you don't break any clip. Then looks like on this top one, I'm gonna get my screwdriver, two-handed, gently pull off this piece. Then the hardest part, I'm gonna work on this main harness here. Then I should be able to take out the bezel. That was probably what I'd guess the hardest part of the job, taking this thing off. I lost like four clips, and I found them all except one. I just hunting forever. I mean, I think the hardest part is just the first time, it probably comes out hard. So I'm taking this magnet that snaps in here, transferring it to the new one. Then I would transfer my AC units, make sure those are in the right way. Then I'm going to screw the 8.4-inch screen into here. I'll use these same screws that hold the small screen because the screen didn't come with new screws. This AC unit here, you just pop off the two edge tabs just like that and then slip it into the other one, snap it back into place. The screen looks a lot funnier when it doesn't have a bezel around it. That's the whole 4.3-inch screen. With the buttons, everything out. Your 8.4 only fits one way, the ears are different. So just carefully drop it onto the set pins and then insert your four screws. Naturally, it's a lot easier to get the bezel back on than it is to take it off. Just carefully place it in to make sure your ACs are all lined up. Then you just kind of push around the edges. It'll go in a bunch and then you'll go around it again and you'll hear this little final click as it probably seats all the way. So you just go all the way around it. Make sure it's all seated properly. That's the first half done. The screen's in. Now we gotta move down to this lower half. So every problem that I have, you're being a part of. So first I had a little trouble getting this ring off till I got my flathead in there and just gently twist it all the way around. And then you see it comes out of these little slots, which kind of has grooves in this bezel, and it's a snug fit. So all you gotta do is pry it down. But I cannot get this clip figured out. I'm gonna have to study some more videos. I can't get my knob off. It's like a weird clip here. I could like put my screwdriver in it this way or even in here. And I've been trying different things and I just, no matter how I lean it, I can't just pull my knob off, so I gotta keep looking at this. Alright, I figured it out by watching a video again that someone else made. You pull this clip out. There it is. Now my knob. Sweet. That part's done. So that shift knob clip is just this little wedge that you're gonna shove in there when you're done to hold it in place. That's all it is. That they showed in that same video, I'm gonna kinda see if I can pry this. He said from the sides. I don't wanna break anything. Oh, there we go, there we go. There we go. Oh, the rubber piece he also mentioned in the other vid, which is really what's helping me with everything. The originators, a Nav TV or something. Give him a little credit. And the same thing happened with him with the rubber plate. Last clip. And I will undo. Whoa. One wire there. Looks like I can push that little button and disconnect this thing just to get out of my way. So that pops out nice and easy. Now you can see these two screws, which you need to undo to take out this lower pocket area. Then you can work on this piece as the last step. Now I'm gonna, got my pockets all out. I'm gonna try popping this thing out without breaking anything. That was much easier than the top dash bezel. Just did it with my hands. Pulled on the bottoms first and carefully popped the tops. So now I have to disconnect this one wire, and here we see the deck that we've been trying to get to. Now you have your four screws to pull out the deck. The deck can come out a little hard. You might think there's some more screws, but there's not. You just have to real gently wiggle it. In a factory seal, everything's super hard and tight, so I was eventually able to slide it out. This is the last harness that I'm having trouble getting out. I've read about the red clip there, but I've been trying to slide it either direction and I can't get it to slide yet. I'm gonna have to research more on this before I break something. Always stop and take a breather if you're not getting somewhere. Alright, maybe I was tripping, but I found this other press point, the other side. I just pushed them both and it slid right off. I'm sure this red piece has something to do with it. Maybe I already had it where it should be, but it came off without any problem. Before I put these in, I'll give you a quick overview. This is my old one. Two antennas, one that really important piece, and two harness, and a USB down there. Little different spots on the RB5, same idea. You still got your two antennas. You got your two harnesses, the same. And you got your, I will use the gray USB just because it's the same color as that one. You can probably use either one. And then you have your master connection there. I'm gonna go reverse all the connections. Okay, I'm putting my climate control back on. Cool thing is you have a little empty hole here to go over this SD card slot until you can get the new bezel if desired to then have that SD slot available. So this front cover is still gonna fit fine. Just one more trick while I'm putting my shift knob back on. See that red? That is actually your shifter release, a secret hatch, so you can remove your little cubby from there. And then you just push down on that with a screwdriver, and it allows you to move this without the key. I kind of found out by accident when I had it off on how to move my shift lever out of the way. But if you ever need to put it in neutral and you can't start it, pull out your cubby and press down on that. It's like a little red button. Alright, I swear to God, I have not even tested this yet. You are testing it with me for the first time. My heart's pounding, I'm nervous as hell if this will work. Roll my windows. Oh yes, good start, good start. Oh hell yeah. These were brand new parts. A lot of people like the used stuff. Of course, I'm blocked here. I did anticipate this. I gotta go to the freaking dealer. I thought that since this was brand new, you wouldn't have to do this code thing. But I'm gonna have to go to the dealer with my VIN, maybe a proof of invoice of buying this thing, so they can give me my code so I can use it. So, a little disappointing, but I was 50% expecting this. So I have to now go get the code before I can use this. This is good for any thieves, because they can't steal this and use it anywhere else without the code. At least it works. That's pretty sweet. See you later. Remember, there was just one clip I was missing. After a spirited drive this morning, it fell out onto the floor. So killer. It's my last clip. Now I know that there's no loose clips floating around anywhere in the car, which is good for peace of mind. So I'll just snap that back in. Then this old piece is good for storage. And even better news, when I got in the car this morning, the lock was gone. So with a brand new unit, I heard rumors that it automatically mates, and that turns out to be true. I just didn't leave it long enough. I'm gonna go ahead and keep my volume off. If I play even one song, I'll get a copyright violation notice. I'll show you real quick. Everything's working perfect, and I just swapped over my Sirius account. So your first tab, radio, AM, FM, and satellite with a Sirius. And your USB stick, which has album art, actually. I know where there's some album art. Let me see. You got album art there and stuff. I think it's a Grace Notes type of thing. So when it knows the album to do it, you can press play again and it'll go to your phone and your Bluetooth. If I had the phone in the car, and it'll play off your streaming, your Pandora, your Spotify, stuff like that. Controls, there's not much. You can turn the screen off for good and you just tap it to turn it on. Climate controls. Have to go up one more step. Climate controls work up here. You can also use these lower buttons, but everything works here too. Dual zone, separate that side. There's some sync it up. And I just keep it on auto and just choose my temp and let it figure it out. Turn off climate. Next tab is the navigation. It's the Garmin navigation stuff. And I don't have a phone connected right now. Settings is cooler than that tiny screen. Remember, I showed you that in a video. You can see everything in a nice big list. It's so much easier to handle. And that last one, a tiny screen, it was so many ups, downs, so many menus. You can see every setting right here. Just check mark it, take it off. Doors, locks, horns. Delete Sirius channels to skip your channels, stuff like that. That's about it. It's not too crazy and fancy, but it's pretty killer. A lot better than a 4.3. The Super Bees have the SRT performance pages on the MFD in your cluster. It does not work here. This has been confirmed with Super Bees before. And even when someone brought their car to the dealer, had it flashed for the RB5 so it expects it, you still don't get SRT pages, 0 to 60s on the big screen. So that's just a feature. It just doesn't work with the Super Bees. But that's it. I'm not even going to play any music. And this one was successful. Next, you can look forward to testing of JBL dash speakers, which should arrive in a day or two. And I'll see if I have clearance to run them or not. They're a real good speaker. All right, see you next time.